गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, सिट इन सुखासन, हैंड्स रेस्टिंग ऑन द नीज इन ज्ञान मुद्रा और चिन मुद्रा, सिट एरेक्ट, क्लोज योर आईज, स्टार्ट प्रेयर. असतो मा सद्गमया, तमशो मा ज्योतिर्गमया, मृत्योर्मा अमृतंगमया. ओम सहनाववतु, सहनो भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु, मा विद्विषावहै. ॐ शांति 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 शांति. हरिः ॐ तत्सत्. ॐ नमः.
Dear viewers, our yoga class today with the great information. Today we are going to discuss respiratory related issues such as cold and sinusitis. For the kind information that we already discussed common cold, that is cold, now we are going to see sinusitis. What are the symptoms of sinus infection? The symptoms of sinusitis are similar to those of a common cold. They may be include a decreased sense of smell, fever, stuffy or runny nose, headache, cough. These are the symptoms that can easily identified that you are affected with sinusitis. How can one prevent a sinus infection? Because sinus infections can develop after a cold or flu or allergic reactions. A healthy lifestyle and reduce your exposure to germs and allergens can help prevent an infection. To reduce your risk, you can get your flu vaccine shot every year. Eat healthy foods such as fruits and vegetables. Wash your hands regularly. Limit your exposure to smoke, chemicals, pollen, allergens, or irritants. Make antihistamine medication to treat allergies and cold.
Sit in Vajrasana position. Place your both hands on your knees. Sit erect. Close your eyes. Exhale, bring your head down, touching your chest with your chin. Inhale, bring your head upwards, stretching backwards. Repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Now we move on to the next one, neck turning movement. Exhale, turn your head to your left side. Inhale, bring it to normal position. Exhale, turn your head to your right side. Inhale, bring it to normal position. Repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, relax. Slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Now we move on to the next one, neck sideways bending movement. Exhale, bend your head to the left side of your body. Inhale, bring it to the normal. Exhale, bend your head to the right side of your body. Inhale, bring it to the normal position. Repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, relax. Slowly breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now we switch over to the next movement. It is called neck rotation. Exhale, bring your head down, touching your chest with your chin. Rotate your head from right side to the halfway. Inhale, complete the rotation by bringing it to the normal position. Do it for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, relax. Now we do it anti-clockwise. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, relax. Breathe in slowly, breathe out slowly. Breathe in, breathe out. Now we start hand movements. Hand movements help us in relieving the stress in the hands and help us in strengthening hands. Now we start the first one, fingers clenching movement. First, stretch your hands to your shoulder level. Exhale, close your fingers covering your thumb. Inhale, release your fingers. Now we repeat this for 3 times. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Put your hands down, relax. Breathe in slowly, breathe out slowly. After every movement, we should breathe in, breathe out slowly for at least 2 times. The second movement, wrist bending movement. First, stretch your hands to your shoulder level. Exhale, bring your palm downwards. Inhale, bring them upwards. Now we repeat them for 3 times. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Relax. Put your hands down. Breathe in, breathe out. Now we start wrist rotation movement. Stretch your hands to your shoulder level. Fold your fingers and rotate your wrist clockwise. Rotate them for 4 times. Now we rotate them in anti-clockwise direction. Rotate them in anti-clockwise direction for 4 times. Relax. Put your hands down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now we start elbow bending movement. Stretch your hands to your shoulder level, palms facing upwards. Exhale, place your fingers to rest on your shoulders. Inhale, release them. Now we repeat this for 3 times. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale, relax. put your hands down. Breathe in, breathe out. Now we start shoulder rotation movement. First, stretch your hands to your shoulder level, palms facing upwards. Exhale, place your fingers to rest on your shoulders. Join your elbows. Inhale, rotate your elbow clockwise to the halfway. Exhale, bring them to normal position. We repeat this for 3 times. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Repeat the same in the anti-clock direction. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Now relax. Put your hands down slowly. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Let's start Vajrasana. Let us see the benefits of this Vajrasana. This asana improves digestion, and with regular practice, it eliminates constipation. Now let's see the technique of this Vajrasana. Sit in Dandasana. Exhale as you sit back on your legs. Put your hands on your thighs. Put your hands on your thighs, sit erect and close your eyes. Breathe in and out slowly as you position yourself to sit up straight. And relax. Now we switch over to the next asana, which is also called Shashankasana. This is also called rabbit pose. Now see the advantages of this rabbit pose. The abdominal organs and muscles are strengthened. The digestive power is also boosted. The face and brain will get augmented flow of blood. Now let us see the technique of this Shashankasana. Sit in Vajrasana. Straighten the back. Inhale and exhale slowly by raising the arms, keeping them straight. Now exhale and bend forward. The arms, trunk, and head should remain in one line. The arms, head, and trunk should remain in one line. The forehead and arms should rest on the floor in front of the knees. Relax the whole body. Inhale and exhale slowly. Relax. Now let us switch over to the next one. Ustrasana. This is also called camel pose. Now let's see the benefit of this Ustrasana. It improves digestion, stretches and opens the front of the body. It also strengthens the back and shoulders. relieves the body of lower back ache, improves flexibility of the spine and also improves posture, helps overcome menstrual discomfort. Let us look at the technique of this Ustrasana. Sit in Vajrasana. Your knees should be in line with the shoulders and the sole of your feet should be facing the ceiling. As you inhale, draw your hands onto your back and bend backwards and stay put for some time. Relax. Sit in Vajrasana.
Stand on knees, stabilizing and start here. Sit in Vajrasana, stand on knees.
And stand on your knees. Now, stretch your hands outside. Bring your left hand, holding your left ankle, and raise your right hand and look upwards. Relax. Now, bring your right hand back, holding your right ankle, and raise your left hand upwards and look upwards. Relax. Sit Vajrasana. Now stand on knees, stretch both your hands forward and bring both your hands backward, holding both the ankles and bend backwards.
Relax.
Hands down. Sit Vajrasana. Relax.
Start.
Now switch over to the next one, Marjalasana. Let's see the benefits of this Marjalasana. It stretches the back, torso and neck. It provides a gentle massage to the spine and belly organs. Now let's see the technique of this Marjalasana. First, sit in Vajrasana. Form the tabletop position. Align the knees directly below your hips. Exhale, round the spine toward the roof. Inhale, now inhale and bring your spine downward and raise your head. Repeat the postures like inhaling and exhaling. While you raise your head upwards, bring your spine downwards. Now exhale. Now inhale and bring your spine downward and raise your head. Relax. Sit Vajrasana. Now stretch your legs out. And bring yourself to Dandasana.
Inhale, exhale.
Inhale and exhale.
Relax.
Relax. Samasthiti. Now let's start Gomukhasana. It is also called cow pose. It is called cow pose since it resembles cow face. Let's see the benefits of this Gomukhasana. It helps curing sciatica. It relieves stress from lower and upper back. And it strengthens muscles in both hands and legs. Let's see the technique of this Gomukhasana. Now, fold your right leg and bring your right feet under your left hip. Now, fold your left leg and bring it beside your right thigh. Make sure your both knees are one on the other. Now, slowly raise your left hand and bring it back to interlock it with right hand. Now relax. Now let's do the same Gomukhasana in the opposite direction. Fold your left leg and bring your left feet under your right hip. Next, fold your right leg and bring it beside your left thigh. Make sure your both knees are one on the other. Now slowly raise your right hand and bring it back to interlock it with left hand. Relax. Now, Dandasana. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let us start Janu Sirasana. Janu means knee. Siramu means head. Since you touch your head with your knee, it's called Janu Sirasana. Now let's see some benefits of this pose. It reduces abdominal fat. It strengthens and flexes backbone. Now let's see the technique of this Janu Sirasana. First, Samasthiti. Hold your right leg to see that your palm reaches your pelvic. Raise your both hands up and slowly bend forward to hold your big toe. And touch your knee with your head. Relax. Bring your hands down. Release your leg. Slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Samasthiti. Now let's do it with the left leg. Fold your left leg to see that your palm reaches your pelvic. Now raise your hands up and slowly bend forward to hold your big toe. touch your right knee with your head. Hold there for a few seconds. Relax. Now bring your hands down. Release your leg. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Now let's start Purvottana Asanam. Slowly raise your whole body up, balancing on your both hands and both feet.
And fully bend back.
Bend your head completely. Now relax. Dandasana. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Dandasana. Now we switch on to Vakrasana. First, fold your right leg and bring it beside your left thigh. Raise your left hand and bring it around your right knee and touch your right feet. Stretch your right hand to your back and turn back side. Relax. Now we do this Vakrasana with the other leg. Now fold your left leg and bring it beside your right thigh. Raise your right hand and bring it around your right knee and touch left feet. Stretch your left hand to your back and turn back side. Turn back side as much as you can. Relax. Dandasana. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale.
Yoga Nidra. The yogic power nap and why you need it. You need to know it. Yoga brings deep rest to the body and mind. It is not only rejuvenates your mind but also adds vigor to the body. It's a good idea to end your daily yoga practice with Yoga Nidra or yogic sleep. Simply described as effortless relaxation, Yoga Nidra is essential end to any yoga pose sequence. While yoga poses warm up the body, Yoga Nidra cools it down. This closing yoga asana involves consciously taking your attention to different parts of body and relaxing them. Yoga practices increase the energy levels in the body. Yoga Nidra helps conserve and consolidate this energy and relax the entire system, thereby preparing it for this energy for pranayama and meditation. It is therefore important to keep aside sufficient time for yoga nidra in your yoga time. How to do yoga nidra? So there are some steps that tell you how to do this yoga nidra. Let us see them. Lie down straight on your back in cobra's pose, that is Shavasana. Close your eyes and relax. Take a few deep breaths in and out. Remember to take slowly and relaxed breaths 2 to 5 times. Start gently taking your attention to your right foot. Keep your attention and concentration there for a few seconds while relaxing your foot. Then gently move your attention up to the right knee, right thigh and hip. Become aware of your whole right leg. Repeat the same process to the left side. That is, concentrate now on left foot. Keep your attention there for a few seconds while relaxing your foot. Then gently move your attention up to the left knee, left thigh and hip. Now become aware of your whole left leg. Pay your attention to the all parts of body, stomach, relax, navel region, relax, and chest, relax. Pay your attention to the right shoulder, right arm, palms, and fingers. Repeat this on the left shoulder, left arm, throat, face, and finally to the top of head. Take a deep breath in and observe the sensations in your body. Relax in this position for a few minutes. Slowly aware of your body and surroundings, turn your right side lying down for a few more minutes, rolling over to the right side and makes the breath flow through the left nostril, which helps cool the body. Take your own time. You may then slowly sit up, and whenever you feel comfortable, slowly and gradually open your eyes.
Tara Mudra. Oh. Start Swasti prayer. Thank you.